the key, I suppose, to maximizing the amount of grass utilized is knowing how much grass you have and when to go into the appropriate covers. So if we target going into our covers of 15 or 1600 kilos of dry matter per hectare, we can make the best chance of utilizing the most grass in that paddock.
So John, we're up in Frank Crinian's farm in County Meath, and we're talking about grass utilisation, and we're looking at some of the initial results of the grazing trial and where the tetraploid varieties seem to be higher utilisation than the diploid varieties. Apart from choosing tetraploid varieties, how can farmers manage their grass to get better utilisation?
They just need to keep probably the management piece simple. The most important thing is the grass growing season is a long season. The essential part is to get a really good start on that. So what I would say is from the word go, you need to be aiming to keep your residuals low. Ideal targets would be 4 or 4.5 centimetres. Now look, it's not always practical to get that, but I think get as low as you can at the start, because that has a huge effect in terms of quality then that follows through for the whole season. If you start too high, you know, the reproductive part of that grass plant is going to get higher and higher and higher, and it'll become less palatable, and the utilisation piece within the grass then is going to be affected by that.
What about pre-grazing height? How do we best keep leafy grass in front of the cows to try and maximise utilisation?
Ideally you're aiming for like anything between, you know, 12 to 1450, 1500 kgs of dry matter per hectare. I think within those parameters, you're probably hitting a lot of the targets in terms of the quality of the grass will be good. It'll be palatable. So if it's palatable because it's not as much reproductive grass within the swart, you'll have more utilization. And again, it goes back to the key. There is no point in growing a lot of grass if it's not going to be utilized. Yeah. You know, and that's why I suppose DLF, we focus on that in terms of utilization being the key driver of grass management. You want the cow to graze as much as she can, so that's a key part. Like,
yeah, and I guess it's important to remember that the post-grazing sward height is as important as your pre-grazing. We're all obsessed nearly with how much grass we're growing and the yields, but we tend to forget about what residuals we're leaving behind. And as you said, leaving higher residuals will reduce the quality of the grass in the next round. So it's all linked up and it all adds up to utilisation.
Oh, it does. Like, and it's key. Grass management, you can make it as difficult as you like, but it's actually very straightforward. If you get the residual correct, you get your pre-grazing height correct, and then the cows are just literally going back in the loop again, and they're coming back to where they need to start again in terms of to get the residual low again. Throughout the course of the year, then, no matter whether you're hitting 8 grazings or 10 or 11 grazings, I guarantee your quality and your utilization will actually be very uniform, and you won't see those fluctuations in the tank in terms of production either, because the cows are getting the same quality of feed nearly with every grazing, regardless of the effect that you might have in terms of maybe a heading date or quality issues during the year because of drought or whatever. I think if you can flatten that curve, you'll actually have better utilization at the end of it all, and your production, whether it be beef or milk or whatever, you won't have those big jumps up or down. Like,
yeah, so like we're managing the grass like it's a living thing as well.
Yeah.
So we're managing the grass to try and make it do what we want it to do.
You can make this as complicated as you like, but it's actually very straightforward. And if you meet the best grassland managers, they look at an awful lot of things. They're looking at their grass quite often, they're measuring their grass, and again, when you're measuring, you're able to manage that whole thing a little bit better. They're doing a lot of stuff really simply, and when they're doing it simply, you see the value that they're getting out of grass. There's people there that are grazing cows from Frank Crinian above in Meath, one of our monitor farms, has cows out in January, and potentially Frank could have cows in still out on grass in October, November. So there is huge potential to gain an awful lot of forage and feed from grass. But if you don't start correct, you're playing catch up for the whole year. Yeah. You know,
the grass is in control then.
Yeah, and if you're chasing grass, and often you talk to a lot of farmers, they'll tell you they nearly prefer managing grass when it's scarce rather than when there's an abundance. It's actually easier to manage. Now you have to be careful there too, because the danger would be that if you graze grass at too low a cover, say if you were to go in and maybe only hitting like 900 or 950 or 1000 covers, and I know you're going to cover this off after, but if you're grazing grass and you're not at that three leaf stage, what you're actually doing is you're not allowing the grass to gain a little bit of energy in itself to create that regrowth burst that you get at the start of the next rotation. So your quality like might look very good, but if you're going in a too low a cover, the issue there is then the cows are having to take an awful lot of bites to gain what they need for in terms of dry matter intakes for the day, so they're actually having to work very, very hard to get it in. So there is a balance. Like, quality is very important, but you always have to consider what's happening for the next round. Yeah. You know, so again, aim for that 4 or 4.5 centimeter residual. On the other side of it, then trying to go in at between 1200, 1500. I mean, if it goes to 1600, it's not the end of the world. But as you start climbing higher on that thing, what'll happen is you'll end up with more reproductive parts of the grass,
and
quality will be going out of that, and beyond that, like, again, just keep everything simple, you know.
Thanks, John. Some really useful tips in there. So John mentioned the three-leaf principle, and he mentioned pre- and post-grazing sward height targets. And the reason behind these targets is they're a good outline for managing the plant to keep good quality grass in front of the animal and to maximise our utilisation. So at the three-leaf stage, when we have three leaves on the plant, we're kind of at that sweet spot between grass quality and grass yield. So at the three-leaf stage, we're just before that reproductive stage. Once we get to a fourth leaf, where the plant is starting to lignify, it's starting to elongate its stem, and it's starting to lose quality. But also at the three-leaf stage, the plant is starting to build its energy reserve before it sets the stem. So if we come in and we graze down to 4 centimetres at the three-leaf stage, we're leaving a nice little reserve of energy for the plant to regrow. And at the height of the season, this regrowth is going to be in your 18 to 21 days. So if we go too far outside those guidelines for pre- and post-grazing sward heights, we can end up doing damage to the plant long-term if we go in too early. And by grazing the plant before it's built up this reserve, we can really decrease the persistence of the plant and damage the plant. But then on the other hand, if we go in too late and too late of an interval between grazing, and we've got a high mass of forage built up, the plants will have started to lignify and they'll be going to set stem, and we'll be trying to get cattle to graze really tough, stemmy forage. So the pre-grazing sward height, the post-grazing sward height are all related, and they all feed into how much grass you can utilise.